Hi and welcome. I'm John and this is Unique Wargaming Terrain. Following on from the mushroom video, I haven't attempted the tree experiment yet. I was going to do part of it into the tree, but I haven't tried that yet. Just haven't had time. But this is what we had. We turned it to mushrooms. Okay. Now in this video, the bits that you cut off at the end, the little knobbly bits, okay, and the bits that were when you use expanding foam, it doesn't quite come out right. The left bits on there on the greaseproof paper. This is what we're going to use today. I'm going to turn these into some nice bits of terrain. So if you're new to the channel, welcome guys. Sit back and enjoy. If you're a regular, again, thank you guys. I appreciate all the love you give me. Sit back and enjoy, and let's get making. Right, so the first thing we're going to say to you is, make a base for it. Now, some of you go, oh, let me get a 3-inch by 3-inch, and no, don't forget all that. These bits are all off-cut bits that normally be thrown away, okay? The reason I'm showing you this now, rather than going straight onto the next bit of expanded foam, is because once you know this, any off-cuts you have from that, you can do the same thing again, or you can do something different. So here I've got a piece of weatherboard, yeah? When it comes to the pretty pictures, I've already done this with other bits and pieces, and you'll see what I mean. What I'm going to say now, you'll see what I mean then. Don't worry about getting it perfectly square and cut. Just, you want to have a really off-cut piece, okay? Now, luckily, I've got this piece. So, but this is not going to be, it's good, but it's not going to be enough to put all of them on one piece. So what I'm going to have to do is probably cut 2, maybe 3 bits. So I'm going to get on with cutting that and sanding that and beveling the edges. You don't need to see that because you've seen it already. If you have a question, how do I do that? Just comment below and I'll show, you know, I'll do it in the next video. I'll show you how to do that, okay? So I'll see you in a second, guys. All right, so all I've done is bevel the base, cut bevel bases, and hot glued the bits on. That's it. It's as simple as that. Yeah? Now, with this one, I did cut trim a little bit here. Don't be afraid to, you know, cut and trim. It's off-cut piece. It's normally you'd throw it away. So if you want to cut and shape it a little bit, work away. Look, there's a little knobbly bit that was on the other bits. Let's cut it off. I said, oh, let me stick it there. Yeah, so it's hot glued up onto the base. So what I would do now with that is I'm going to filler mix it. Okay, I don't need to show you that. You've seen me do that. Again, if you want a bit more information or something like that, check on below. And in the next video that I'm doing filler mix, I will show you filler mixing. Okay, so I'll filler mix that and then I'll get back to you. See you in a second, guys. All right, guys. So here they are. All I've done is I've put filler mixed it. You don't need to see that, but if you do, check on below and I'll show you again. Burnt umber. Okay. And this painter's grey, it's a very dark grey. I mean, it, you're seeing it on here, it looks like it's black, but it's not, a very, very dark grey. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to dry brush, two colour dry brush. Space Wolves grey, which I don't, case which I don't sell it anymore, but I don't think they do anyway. It's just a very, very light grey. So I'm going to wax some on a brush. Very simple. And these are just off-cut pieces. These are off-cut pieces from when we made the mushrooms. And so at the beginning of this video, normally you'd throw them away, but something like this makes excellent pieces for games of 40k. You could even use it in fantasy, I suppose, for games of, you know, Dungeons and Dragons and stuff, and Warcry, and, you know, it's, you can pretty much use it, everything I'm making, you can pretty much use in anything, I suppose. But it's so much easy. Look at that. Just one dry brush colour already. Just go over it again here and there. That one. Nice and simple. Wait for this one. Okay. how simple that is. Now, what I was doing before with the bases, I was putting the burnt umber on, and then I was doing a dry brush of still leading drab, and that was it. Then I started to experiment with the ash from the fire, and I thought that looks pretty good. The thing is, when I done the mushrooms on the last video, if you haven't seen that, guys, go back and see it. I wasn't happy with the way the ash looked against the mushroom. So I'm going to dry brush this with still leading drab, and I'm going to do one of them with a bit of ash on it, okay? Just to see if I can mix them together pretty well. I'm sure they will, because they are pretty similar colours, but they're just a little bit contrasting of each other. Right, a quick dry brush. With me, guys, let's give this a nice little quick dry brush. I'm actually going to do starting in March, I'm going to start doing some giveaways. Okay, so when I make terrain, the terrain I make in February, I'm going to give one of my viewers a chance to win a piece of that terrain in March. But what I want first, I want to hit 30 subscribers, guys. Okay? Hit 30 subscribers, and then I'll start doing giveaways for bits like this. Now, that's nice and easy, nice and done. Right, so all I've got left to do, I'm going to put some PVA glue, I'll leave that 5 minutes dry, put some PVA glue on, I'm going to put some ash on it, but I'm not going to cover the whole thing, I'm going to put some ash here or there, I might even put some flock here and there, just to jazz up a little bit. I'm going to leave one plane and do this one with a bit of ash and a bit of flock, and then we'll go to some pretty pictures. So I'm going to do that off camera, and next time you see, there'll be pretty pictures. Guys, see you in a second. Alright, and here we have it, guys. This is one that's been done previously, okay? Here's another example of a previous one. As you can see, that, let's see these bits here. These are actually bits of weatherboard that was off-cut pieces. I just cut them and just glued them to a little pile of rubbish. There's the one. There's the one I'm just working on. Some flock and some of the ash from the fire. There's the other piece. Yeah, so guys, which one do you think looks better? With a flock and ash, or just the ash, or just plain. Okay, so with just the ash, with the flock and the ash, or just plain. Okay, so there's some Space Marines. So you can see how nice they look. If I move one or two in there, they fit there nicely. Okay, let's move some into this one. Okay, they look absolutely amazing there. So, there's a pretty pictures, guys. I'll see you in a second. Guys, so it's as simple as that. Nice and easy. The off-cut piece, off-cut board, filler mix, paint, and you've got a nice piece of terrain as well to go with it. If you've got a cityscape, you can use that here and there, like a number of those here and there, and it just gives you more options on the battlefield. So if you like this video, guys, please hit the like, share, subscribe, and turn on your notifications. As I was saying a minute ago in this video, once I hit 30 subscribers, I'm going to start doing giveaways. Now, the way this is going to work is I usually make a video a week. So let's just, so we're in January now, so February, the four videos I make in February, when it comes to March, one of the people, I will give that one of those pieces of terrain away. And all you have to do is subscribe. Tell me you subscribed. I can check that afterwards. And, you know, but I'm only going to start doing this when we hit 30 subscribers. I know there's people that watch the videos that I make. Notifications are on, but I don't subscribe. Guys, come on. Let's get this channel growing. Until next time, guys. See you later.